No matter how you know, get it done. 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 Okay, people, so I wanted to preface this rant with saying that at the end of the day, you watching, the viewer, you're going to do what you're going to do anyway. You have free will. And ultimately, I'm just here, a guy giving my opinion on things. I'm not here to try and control how you consume your media, how you consume your entertainment. All I'm doing is giving a kind of passionate rant to a certain degree. So I want to stress that I'm not here trying to control anybody's way of enjoying anime or manga. Now, with that being said, I do feel like this one is a long time coming as well, long time, many years, in particular regarding fans that like to skip stuff in anime. Now, there's exceptions to when you can skip some stuff. Absolutely. I feel as though, for starters, filler, true to blue filler, not just like, you know, anime canon as it's been coined as of recent or whatever, but true to blue filler. For example, like my nephew, he was too young when we originally watched Naruto together, so now he actually took it that he was interested in it and he wanted to watch it, so he went back and watched all of Naruto, and I recommended him. I was like, yo, episode 135 through 220 is filler. You probably don't want to waste your time with it. You probably want to jump straight to Shippuden, maybe watch 220 at the end to see Naruto and Jiraiya go off or whatever. But yeah, go skip that. I recommend that. Go skip it because it has no continuity. It has no bearing over the overall story. You could argue that maybe there was some, you know, character development or whatever, but we've seen time and time again, especially in Naruto and Naruto Shippuden, that usually filler doesn't amount to anything. And in fact, it gets ignored oftentimes, such as like one of the tailed beast Jinchuriki, I think it was Utakata, his whole filler arc was ignored and they acted like Naruto never met him when he actually was introduced to meeting Naruto in the canonical stuff. So oftentimes, yeah, when it comes to filler, skip that shit. Hands down, go ahead. Do you just jump straight to the next stuff? There's usually filler guides out there as well. Like if you're watching Naruto, for example, put Naruto filler guide and skip. Likewise with One Piece, Bleach, etc., etc. So I'm not saying that there's no, you know, instances where like, hey, you should skip stuff. But what I am saying is that there are some egregious offenders out there. We're going to talk about these people. I got to put you on blast right now if you're watching this and you're like, oh no. Some egregious offenders out there that they skip vital information that later on leaves them left confused, left to kind of throw out opinions that are very uninformed. And if they had simply stuck through the material, they would understand. Like for starters, I'm gonna give you a perfect example. JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. There is this running gag, and I'm gonna call it a gag because in actuality it's a serious thing of people saying you should skip part one, the very beginning of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure part one with Jonathan and Dio, that is about in the anime 9 episodes, I want to say. You should skip that because it's the weakest part. And I ain't gonna lie, when people say that, I get infuriated. Not because, oh my god, it is a masterpiece, even though I really love part one as well. I love all of JoJo's, but in particular, I love part one. But ultimately, it is the groundwork for the entirety of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, at the very least, the first 6 parts. You can connect every part of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure to that first part. And if you don't have that groundwork, you're not going to understand why in part 3, it is so epic to see Dio return. Mind you, there's a little bit of a plot hole of how he returned, but ultimately, you're not going to understand why he's so freaking epic. You're not going to understand how every part connects to part 1, whether it be the Pillar Men, whether it be the mask, whatever it may be. Dio Brando in particular, in his introduction, is connected to everything in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure's part 1 through 6. And if you skip that first part, you're going to be left saying, well, what's so epic about Dio, and why is he connected to this character, and why was he the mentor to this character? Like, you're gonna be there lost and saying certain things like Dio ain't that awesome, and not understanding that no, Dio is very awesome. The first episode alone, the first 2 episodes of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, I'd argue, are some really strong stuff. And I get it that probably midway through, when Jonathan goes on his adventure and it starts getting into that more freak of the week type thing, that maybe some people I guess fell out of the plot, so to speak, even though part 3 did it, and I guess part 3 was more refined. But ultimately, point being is that you're not gonna understand why Dio Brando is so freaking awesome. awesome if you skip part one. You're not going to understand how everything is connected to part one. You're not going to understand how it's the catalyst. It's the freaking beginning of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. How can you skip that and jump straight through to part two or three? You're like, I don't understand. And I get it that there's some certain instances of where you had no choice back then. And what I mean by back then is because now everything is readily available to you. You go to Crunchyroll, you go to Funimation, Netflix, all of it is there. You can go watch from the very beginning. So now you have a little bit of a choice, which kind of makes it worse for the people that, like, yeah, you have no excuses now, like, I didn't have it available. However, there are some instances, even going to JoJo's as well, of, yo, back then we didn't have an option. You know what I'm saying? Like, back then we had the OVAs for part three, and the part three manga was, I want to say, I don't know if it, in its entirety, but it was released over here in the US, and that was about it. So you had no choice back then. Understandable. Likewise, to a certain degree, although you should have long time ago corrected this mistake. Likewise with Dragon Ball. A lot of people, they never even watched Dragon Ball, the OG Dragon Ball, and in fact, they refuse to. They say there's no Super Saiyan power-ups, there's none of that stuff. They jump straight to Z. Unfortunately, back in the day, we had no choice because we were thrusted straight into Z because I want to say back in like early mid 90s, they tried to put Dragon Ball on TV. It didn't work. And then when they put Z on TV, it blew up. And there's a lot of people out there right now in this day and age that actually believe that Dragon Ball starts off with Raditz and Goku, not realizing that there's a whole 153 episodes of Goku as a kid and his coming of age. And the crazy shit about it is, and a lot of people hold this opinion as well, OG Dragon Ball, some of the best stuff of the entirety of the Dragon Ball franchise. People argue that Dragon Ball is better than Z, GT, Super, etc., etc. It is an amazing story of martial arts, lessons, comedy, a very nice blend. And I think that's also attributed to why people, when Battle of Gods came out, weren't really rocking with it, because Battle of Gods kind of combined that feeling you got of the epic battles and the climaxes and all that jazz that you got from Z, but also some of the stuff that OG Dragon Ball fans loved, the comedy, all of that vibe that you got from original Dragon Ball was kind of blended in, because original Dragon Ball was more, in my opinion, true to who Akira Toriyama, the author of Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, etc., who he is as an artist, as a storyteller. He loves jokes, he loves comedy, he loves giving you a whole bunch of different vibes, not just action. So when Battle of Gods came through and you got all these jokes and all of this zaniness, people were like, where's my, you know what I'm saying, where's my Vegeta theme, where's the tears, where's the destruction and shit like that. People didn't understand that that was actually true to blue Dragon Ball. And again, that's because a lot of people skipped it. That one is an exception to a certain degree because, hey, you didn't know better. Understandable. A lot of us didn't. When we were little, we just knew, holy shit, the Saiyans are coming. What's going on here? Now you don't got an excuse, considering especially you got people like me telling you that Dragon Ball is arguably better than Z and GT, etc., etc. And again, that's just my opinion. Maybe you think totally different, and that's totally fine. But if you do think different, that means that you probably actually gave it a try, original Dragon Ball, or you watched it. And if that's the case, I'm fine with you, fam. My argument, my beef is not with you. My beef is the people that say, oh, Z is better, original Dragon Ball is trash, there's no Super Saiyan in it, there's no Super Saiyan Blue, there's no Super Saiyan God. Like, what the, what? I thought you go to anime for some really awesome storytelling, which Dragon Ball houses. Like, what? Ooh, and another one. This one is a little bit of a different animal, because again, there was the excuse for JoJo's that back in the day, you know, part three was the only thing available. Now there's no excuse. You could go on Netflix right now and watch, I think, the first four parts alone. Likewise with Dragon Ball, you could go on Funimation, watch the entirety from episode 1 through 153, then 1 through 291, then GT, if you want to watch GT, which over the years, I've come to appreciate GT more. I just want to throw that in there. And then, of course, Super, like, you can go and make up for those mistakes. However, there's one that from the very beginning, I would argue, has been a purposeful skipping and mistake regarding One Piece. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all probably right now, oh, I know what Forever World is about to mention. And you're right. I guarantee you're probably right, because no land was not a lawyer. What? Skypiea. That is one of the things since early on. I go back to like 2010 when I first started really hardcore getting into One Piece. A lot of people said, oh, you could skip Skypiea. See, I'm a completionist. I don't like skipping stuff unless it's like, oh, okay, this is filler. It's really just like god-awful filler. It has no bearing down the road. They're gonna act like this never happened. Then I'll throw in, okay, whatever. But Skypiea is a full-on canonical piece of the One Piece story. It's in the manga and the arc in the anime. Granted, it's a little bit long, but ultimately it's canonical and there's epic stuff in there. There's Enel. There's a lot of really cool things, but especially there's important stuff that overall connects to the entirety of One Piece with Nolan the Liar, the Bell, Roger's connection to going up to Skypiea, how many times we flashed back or people that went to Skypiea and how important that was, a part of their journey. Just in general, the overall connection to everything with like Joy Boy and shit like that. There's so much richness to Skypiea, and there's a lot of people walking around right now that are commenting and watching One Piece videos that skip that shit and acting like nothing ever happened, and then they're confused, and then they're saying, oh, that shit is boring, that shit is whack. You didn't even watch it. You took somebody's recommendation that was very misinformed themselves that told you, oh yeah, you could just skip Skypiea. You cannot skip Skypiea. In fact, if you skip Skypiea, go rectify that situation right now. Either go read it or go watch it, because you've done yourself a disservice, especially endgame One Piece story right now. Skypiea is very important. What are you doing? Why did you do that? Why did you purposefully skip out on stuff that is very important to the overall One Piece world? Now, granted, there is some stuff in Skypiea. You could take it or leave it or whatever, but ultimately, it's still very important, and I wouldn't be surprised if the main villain of that even returns someday because he's so popular, and also, his story was continued on in the cover page stories as well, so there's just so much to One Piece that, in general, like, skipping canonical stuff, you can skip maybe some filler, which One Piece, thankfully, isn't really riddled with filler by any means, so, you know, you could throw the argument there again, pull up a filler guide, but Skypiea, you have really shot yourself in the foot, because now again you're going to be misinformed, you're going to be running around saying this, that, and the third, and it might have been explained, it might have been foreshadowed way back when, and because you decided I'm gonna skip this shit, lad, you're running around like a chicken with his head cut off. So my point in all of this jibber jabber is to say that, can you skip stuff in anime? Yes, certain circumstances, sure, with filler, things that are not, you know, canonical to the story that are going to have no bearing. But ultimately, if you're skipping stuff, especially the beginning or important aspects or just in general, anything that is canonical, you're probably doing yourself a disservice. You're probably going to be confused down the road. You're probably going to say some shit that doesn't make no sense, and people on Twitter are going to come at your ass, boy. Don't skip shit. It's not worth it, fam. It's not worth it. Save yourself the headache, the embarrassment, and overall the struggle. But I'm curious. Let's be a little bit transparent here. Let's throw some confessions out there. Have you watching ever skipped something in an anime or a manga, whether it be an arc, a few episodes that were canonical or important to the story? Maybe you rectified the situation, maybe you haven't, and why? Let me know, honestly. Like, if you're a Skypiea skipper, tell me, why have you not gone back and rectified that situation? That's the beautiful thing about the streaming era now. You don't got to say, well, I don't got the DVDs, it's not airing on TV anymore. You can go on every streaming service damn near and find what you skipped and rectify that situation and be informed and be in the loop and understand the greatness of some of these stories. Original Dragon Ball, greatness. Original JoJo's, very important, and I would argue greatness. Skypiea, One Piece, very important, and greatness. Like, stop skipping shit, fam, unless it's filler, then have at it. But that's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, hit that bell like they did on Skypiea. And if you want to follow any of my other social media, links are in the description below. I'm Fineb World, and as always, people, have an awesome day. And remember the golden rule: stop skipping shit in anime that's important, damn it. Have an awesome one.